Kindly join in our entrance hymn, Here We Are.
Here we are, all together as we sing our song. Joyfully, here we are, all together as we pray we'll always be. Join with our strength to celebrate the brotherhood we share. All is one, keep the fire burning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Once again, a warm welcome to one and all on this eighth day of our Novena in honor of our Blessed Mother. And today, we together reflect on the theme, Mary as the intercessor. An intercessor is a person who pleads on our cause. Mary always pleads on the cause of their sons and daughter. Because we are children of Mary, Mary pleads for our causes. And therefore, this evening we reflect together on this theme, Mary, our intercessor. And now to prepare our hearts and minds to receive Jesus in the Word as well as in the sacrament of the Eucharist. Let us pause for a little while and ask the Lord for sincere pardon for all those times we have failed to reach out to one another. All together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grievously sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we, your servants, may enjoy in unfailing health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, we may be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for the reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brethren, now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake and in my flesh. I am filling up what is lacking in Christ's afflictions for the sake of his body, that is, the church, of which I became a minister according to the stewardship from God that was given to me for you, to make the word of God fully known, the mystery hidden for ages and generations, but now revealed to his saints. To them God chose to make known how great among the Gentiles are the riches of the glory of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Him we proclaim, warning everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom, that we may present everyone mature in Christ. For this I toil, struggling with all his energy, that he powerfully works within me. For I want you to know how great a struggle I have for you and for those at Laodicea, and for all who have not seen me face to face, that their hearts may be encouraged, being knit together in love, to reach all the riches of full assurance of understanding and the knowledge of God's mystery, which is Christ, in whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to your psalm is, in God is my salvation and glory.
In God is my salvation and glory.
In God alone be at rest my soul, for my hope is from him. He alone is my rock, my salvation, my fortress, never shall I falter. Your response?
In God is my salvation and glory.
Trust him at all times, O people. Pour out your hearts before him, for God is our refuge. Response?
In God is my salvation and glory.
Kindly stand as we prepare our hearts for the gospel.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
On another Sabbath, Jesus entered the synagogue and was teaching. And a man was there whose right hand was withered. And the scribes and the Pharisees watched him to see whether he would heal on the Sabbath, so that they might find a reason to accuse him. But he knew their thoughts, and he said to the man with the withered hand, "Come and stand here." And he rose and stood there. And Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful on the Sabbath to do good or to do harm, to save life or to destroy life?" And after looking around at them all, he said to him, "Stretch out your hand." And he did so, and his hand was restored. But they were filled with fury and discussed with one another what they might do to Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Be seated. My dear brothers and sisters, yesterday we focused or reflected together on the theme Mary, Mother of the Church. Today, on the eighth day of our Novena in honor of our Blessed Mother, we reflect on the theme Mary, our intercessor. One who pleads on our behalf is an intercessor. You must also have some background about what is the role of an intercessor. In the Old Testament, whenever the king was at the coronation ceremony, the Queen Mother would also be sitting in that same area as a mark of respect for the king and the mother, Queen Mother, sitting there. And this was a tradition that was followed in the Old Testament. So when Solomon was made king, Bathsheba was also present there as the Queen Mother. Similarly, when Jesus becomes our king, we celebrate the feast of Christ the King. When Jesus is acclaimed as our king of our lives, we also have Mary the Queen Mother to plead on behalf of Jesus' subject who we are. And therefore today, together we will reflect on this theme, Mary our intercessor. One of the most powerful texts of Mary as an intercessor is in John's Gospel chapter 2. When they ran out of wine, Mary pleaded to Jesus of the embarrassing situation of the couple. And Jesus was ready to help, though he said, "My hour is not come." You must watch what Mary does. Mary is not ordering Jesus, Mary is requesting Jesus. Mary is pleading to Jesus as if to say, "If it is your will, you do it." And very interesting, Mary tells the servants, "Listen to him." Mary is not saying, "Listen to me," he says, "Please listen to what my son says." Therefore, the role is very clear. One who grants everything in our life is Jesus. Mary is not goddess. Mary, our Blessed Mother, is also a creature like us, but blessed by God for all that she did doing God's will. A few days ago, we celebrated the feast of the Assumption of our Blessed Mother. From a simple woman of Nazareth, she is raised to the level of being taken body and soul into heaven. Okay, so Mary is raised to that level because she was faithful to God, faithful to Jesus, and faithful to the Word of God. And therefore, Mary has a very powerful role as an intercessor to plead on behalf of us, her children. This is a very normal human experience, if you notice. In our families, if we have to face our father, if you have to face your daddy when you were small, if you have, suppose, got a less mark and you find difficult to express it to daddy to say, "I need the signature here," you're very frightened of daddy. So what you will do, the best thing is, "I know I can't go to daddy," you must say, "Let me tell mommy, you go and take the signature." Because we know mommy will somehow convince daddy and or will be very polite and says, "Okay, she will try next time, he will try next time, but you sign." So the mother is always someone who is ready to plead on our behalf. So Mary does that role of pleading on behalf of her children. Any problem, any difficulties in our lives, I know there are, I used to come here for celebrating Mass on many occasions, and I know the number of people come to this church and because they believe that Mary as an intercessor, because once Mary asks Jesus, it is like Jesus will not grant her request, because Jesus loves Mary very much. And if it is for our good, Jesus will definitely grant. If it is not for our good, Jesus will not grant, because he also loves us. So Mary can only request Jesus. One who really gives is Jesus, because Jesus as God in his wisdom knows what is good for us. So sometime our prayers are answered when he says, "Yes, I will grant you." Sometime God says no. And sometime he says, wait, this is not the right time. So in our own lives, Mary is the one who intercedes on our behalf, leaving it to God to decide what is good for our life. But we as children feel very comfortable to approach Mary to ask Jesus to grant that particular wish of ours. In a very special way, we must pray to Mary for the lost souls. That's why in the Hail Mary we say, "Pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death." 1912, 15th of April, the Titanic sank with 1,500 people in the Atlantic Ocean. Before the Titanic left Southampton, moving towards New York City, there were many compartments in the Titanic. Rich class, poor class, upper class, lower class, all sorts of classes in the Titanic. But when the Titanic sank, there were only two classes of people, lost and found. They only had a register on which, on the left side, it was put, all those who are lost means we never found them on one side, and all those who were found on the other side. Many compartments before leaving, after that only two compartments, lost and found. Life is a journey. On this journey, we are either lost because we don't find in Jesus the fulfillment of our life. Without Jesus, we are lost. With Jesus, we are found. And the one who helps us to find Jesus is Mary, our Blessed Mother. Mary is the one who will tell us, you want to achieve eternal life, listen to my son. You want anything in your life, I will plead for your cause, but you listen to Jesus. Listening to Jesus, we become disciples. As a disciple of Jesus, we need to listen. The word disciple means a learner. We as disciple must learn from Jesus. Mary is called the first and the best and the greatest and a model disciple. Why? Because she heard the word of God kept in her heart and realized that word in her life. She was the one who obeyed the word of God. You notice Eve misled Adam. The new Eve is not misleading Jesus, the new Adam. On the contrary, the new Eve requests Jesus to grant the request of the couple who ran out of wine. In our own lives, with Jesus, we are either found or we are lost. And therefore, we have a greater need to pray to Mary, our intercessor, plead our cause, especially for people who are lost. They have lost. They don't know what's happening in their life. So apart from praying for our own cause, we must also ask Mary to pray, and we should pray people whom we know are lost in their lives, so that through the intercession of Mary, they may be found in and through the person of Jesus. One who grants us eternal life is Jesus. Mary can only plead for us. Therefore, as devotees of our Blessed Mother, we must always remember it is Jesus as God who grants. Mary is not goddess. Mary cannot grant that. Mary can only plead our cause. So if you remember the assumption of our Blessed Mother, the Holy Father, Pope Pius XII, was very careful when he chose the word. Mary was assumed into heaven, taken into heaven by somebody. Who is that somebody? By the power of God. While we call or while we talk about Jesus, we don't say about assumption of Jesus. We talk ascension of Jesus. Ascension means by my own power, I go up because Jesus is God. Mary cannot be assumed by her own power. It is only when Jesus takes her body and soul into heaven. So our center of our life is Jesus. And because Jesus is the center of our life, Mary is the closest to Jesus. And as Queen Mother, she can plead for the cause. And if you read 1 Kings 2:20, when somebody requested, a request was brought to Solomon, he said, I cannot refuse my mother. I will grant that request because the mother is asking. Jesus grants us if it is good for our health. We must always remember that everything that we ask in our life, we don't get, because God knows what is good for us. Like for example, your mother loves you very much. When you were small, mommy would do anything for you. But if you ask your mommy to give knife or a gun, mommy will not give. However you cry, she will not give, because she knows that that particular gun or that knife can harm you. Similarly, God knows what is good for you. If something is going to harm you, He will not grant you. So you must always pray through Blessed Mother, but always learn the prayer of Jesus. If it is your will, give me. If it is not your will, don't give me. So Jesus also was disturbed in the Garden of Gethsemane. He says, I don't want this cup of suffering, but nevertheless, if it is your will, I will take it. Not my will, but your will be done. Every time in the Our Father we say, not thy kingdom come, thy will be done. We must always pray, your will be done, not mine. If it is good for me, give me. If it is not good for me, Lord, give me the grace to accept it as it is. Let us have confidence in Mary, our Blessed Mother, as an intercessor, that she knows what is best for us through Jesus, and therefore she will grant, or at least she will plead our cause, so that Jesus, if it is good for us, will grant it. If not, He will not grant for us. And we should have the courage to say, Thy will be done, not mine. Let's thank God for the gift of Mary, our intercessor, as a mother who intercedes for us. And we pray and we ask Mary in a special way to pray for all those lost souls. so that through her intercession they may find Jesus, the author of eternal life.
Kindly join in our offertory hymn, All Things Are Thine. My dear friends, that mine your sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of the Blessed Mary, mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise and bless and glorify your name. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, gracious Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, to your God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
God is our loving Father. We are all his children. With his confidence, let us pray the very prayer which Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance to your will, lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the risen Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a meaningful sign of God's peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say thy word, and my soul shall be healed.
Now we make a prayer in order to receive the Lord spiritually. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there. and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Novena prayer to Our Lady of Health of Velankanni. O Most Holy Virgin, you were chosen to be the Mother of Jesus. Permit me, your devoted client, to praise you for this unique privilege. O tender Mother, comfortress of the afflicted, grant me the special protection which you have promised to those who venerate you. Relying on the infinite mercies of your divine Son, trusting on his promises that those who ask would receive and penetrate with confidence in your powerful intercession, I most humbly entreat you to obtain from me the favors which I petition for in this novena, if it is the holy will of God, or else whatever grace I am most to stand in need of. Let us pray for our personal needs. Let us also make thanksgiving prayers. In a special way, we pray for all our community members, families, friends and relatives, for the good health and comfort, for the sick and suffering in the hospitals and in our homes, for peace and understanding in the families, for a happy settlement in marriage, for vocation to the priesthood and religious life, for accommodation, for shelter, relief to the poor and marginalized, for the gift of children, for safe confinement, for success in studies, for employment, for promotions, for cure from drugs, alcoholism, and other addictions. Let us also in a special way pray to the Lord that so that he may protect us and heal us from this COVID-19 pandemic. In veneration of the love and joy with which your heart was replenished when the Word was made flesh in your womb, I offer you the sentiments of my heart. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
O Mother of God, accept these salutations in union with the veneration with which the angel Gabriel first hailed you, full of grace. I wish most sincerely that these may become so many germs in the crown of your celestial glory. Mother Mary, to your keeping, soul and body we confide, toiling, resting, walking, sleeping, be ever at our side. Cares that vex us, joys that please us, life and death we trust in you. You make yours all for Jesus and for all eternity. Amen.
Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you once again for your participation. God bless you and your family through the intercession of our Blessed Mother. Before I conclude also, I take this opportunity to thank Father Ravi, the parish priest here, for giving me an opportunity to celebrate the Eucharist with you.
Kindly join in our final hymn, Sing We Now in Praise of Mary.
Oh,
photo.